To magazines and everything in between, beware of salespeople showing up at your door. The Better Business Bureau is issuing some warnings for consumers. Bill Smith is with the Better Business Bureau from St. Louis, joining us now. Hi, Bill. Thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you.
You know, when you say door-to-door sales, I thought that was kind of like a thing of the past, but I guess there are still some scam artists out there trying it.
Yeah, it is still going on, not to the extent that it did in years past, certainly, but we see a lot of door-to-door magazine salespeople. We've recently seen in Southern Illinois a meat sales company doing door-to-door meat sales, large amounts of money, and always there's the home alarm security companies that are looking to switch you over to sell you on a on an alarm system.
Mm-hmm. Now, how do you know a legitimate salesperson coming to your door from one that you got to have some suspicions about?
Well, you should be skeptical of anybody who comes to your door unannounced. If they don't call, they don't have an appointment ahead of time. It's not to say that there aren't some legitimate people who do this. Our recommendation at the BBB is that you talk to them, you get information for them or from them, or ask them to send you information, and not make a decision right there on the spot, because if you do, it's likely to go bad for you. We had a magazine sales company last year that was very big out of Miami, Florida, that was bringing young people through the St. Louis area selling magazines, KLMN readers, and they ended up not delivering, to the best of our knowledge, mm-hmm. any of the magazines that they sold.
Now, what about this meat company? You're saying anything, I guess, perishable could be trying to be sold to anyone. But what is the story about the meat company? Was that not delivered?
This was a company out of Arkansas that was involved with a lady, sold about $2,000 worth of meat and a cheesecake, among other things, to a lady in rural Cobden, Illinois. Although we've seen meat salespeople around this area also. What people need to remember about this is if you do make a purchase of meat or whatever it might be, you basically have a 3-day cooling off period, which means that if you should decide within that 3 days that you don't want what you ordered, you should be able to get a refund of your money by returning the items. Mm-hmm.
Now, some of these traveling salespeople can be very convincing you to buy maybe what you don't need. And, you know, I had an experience not too long ago. Somebody came to the door at about 8 o'clock at night claiming to be from AT&T, mm-hmm. had an AT&T hat, and said, yeah, I'm here just to update your account and check on your system. We're unannounced.
Right. If a consumer has any concerns, and we've heard that with, you know, these could be obviously people casing the place too for possible burglary down the line. Mm-hmm. So that's something you need to be concerned about. If you have any concerns at all, first of all, you know, don't let a stranger into your house. But secondarily, ask them for identification. Write that information down if you have an opportunity to do that. Ask them for a solicitor's permit if your community requires a solicitor's permit. And call the local police department if you have any concerns, and ask them whether or not they are allowed to solicit in your community.
Right. Okay. Bill Smith with the BBB in St. Louis, thanks so much for being with us.
Thanks
appreciate
very much,
Dan. All right, let's send it back to Chandria.
All right, thank you.